Hello mates, it's SoundPix and today we're gonna make unboxing and review of Chinese MIDI controller World E Panda 25, and here is the box of it. Let's check it out. Okay, what we can see here, the disc with user's manual, MIDI cable, and the MIDI. Here how it looks. What I should say, it's pretty big. Here is my hand. Feels heavy. Looks good crafted. Not cheap. Inputs and outputs. By the way, as you can see, there is no any DC charger here, so you should buy separate. It says DC 9 volt. MIDI in, MIDI out. And these jacks are for pedal controls. USB in. Pads, CC, rotaries, some buttons. To me it looks pretty solid. Now let's check how it works. Okay, first thing I want to show you after connecting the keyboard to the computer, that it works fine in Ubuntu and you don't need any extra setup. I just plug it in and I'm using a jack audio connection kit. I have AM synth here, and now we can try to make some noise. So it works fine and I don't need any drivers at all. I didn't try to read manuals. All I can do on a fly is just change octave. Modulation works. So it's just audio connection kit jack, audio connection kit, and AM synth. Now I would like to try using it with Hydrogen. Works fine and I cannot feel any delay, any latency, so I'm pretty happy with this. Now I would like to show you that it is possible to control Hydrogen with this MIDI controller. Here I have some transport buttons and I will try to bind it to Hydrogen control buttons. Let me check. I will connect it to the Hydrogen. I have here something. Stop. Yes. Play. Okay, it works. What about MIDI? Pads. What kind of note? C3. I would like to change it to. Okay. So you can control hydrogen with. I don't remember which MIDI controls is here. Pad 1, pad 2, pad 3, but I will figure it out. All I wanted to show you that it works fine. Okay. Great. So, Worldy Panda 25 works fine with Linux. Now I would like to start Wine FL Studio. Okay, now we see FL Studio. Let me try add some synthesizer. Okay, it works with FL, and I think with the help of some setup, you can bind all these CC buttons to different functions in different synthesizers. Okay, now let's switch to Windows. Okay, now we are in Reason. I don't have any screencast software to show me my desktop, so I just recording it to my camera, and I will tell you what I'm pressing on my MIDI keyboard. So now I want to show you that this MIDI keyboard works fine with Reason, with Reason transport buttons, and you just need to make some setup in preferences. Okay, now make some setup here. Oh, nope, I want this CC118 and play button go. Now let's try. Okay, works fine. Now try. Let's try to use it. Oops. Yeah, so everything works by default, and I didn't need any drivers to connect it to Windows 2. Now let's switch to Cubase. Okay, now we are in Cubase, and I will show you how to make a MIDI setup here. We press devices, device setup, press plus button, generic remote. Now here we need to make some setup. First of all, we choose here Worldy controller Panda. Here we can give a names of our functions we're gonna make. Just random letters. Addresses, it's important. Press learn and press some buttons, play. I'm pushing play, stop. I'm pushing stop. Nice. Now the second part here, You just click it and Cubase automatically adjust the name. What we want to control, device, transport. And I guess here we should use toggle, don't want push. Okay, let's try. Damn, what's up? Device, and here, start, stop. Now it's okay. Okay, it's some old trash. So, works fine. I'm pressing here. Works well. And now let's try to use it in some VSTI. Works fine. And here you can bind any control rotary or button to control this macros right here, like any MIDI setup. You can use learn. Now you can see it's working. It's working. So here this MIDI controller, and I'm pretty happy with it just for more than $80. Thanks for watching. See you next time.